Hello, 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 good people. Hello, good people. I am Dr. Hollie Kelly, and this is Dr. Kelly's Perspective for Thursday, the last Thursday in January 25th, 2018. Okay, so I have a question for you. Can you be trusted? Now, I already know that the first reaction, the first response to jump from your mind and leap through your lips is, yes, of course I'm trustworthy. I can be trusted. People trust me all the time. Hey, Miss Margaret, but here's the thing. This is one question that we don't get to ask and answer. We can ask it, but the answers, the best answer, the probably most reliable answer is going to come from our family, our spouses, our children. The best answers are going to come from our coworkers and colleagues, our team members. See, they get to determine the level of trustworthiness that we display. Hey, Miss Mel, I trust you are well, and of course, Miss Margaret. So they get to determine whether we are trustworthy or at what level we are trustworthy. You know, are you where you're supposed to be when you say you're going to be there? Do you do what you say you're going to do? Do you make the hard calls and the decisions that need to be made? Can you be trusted to do and handle your business? Can people rely on you? I call them like a fire and forget weapon. Can they tell you something? You say, yep, I got it. And they don't have to worry about it anymore because, hey, if Melanie says she got it, if Miss Johnny says she got it, it's handled. If Margaret said it, I don't even have to blink twice. Can you be trusted? Because here's the thing. It's going to show up. Most people, first of all, we don't go around asking. But most people are not going to boldly come out and say, hey, Elder Solomon, most people are not going to boldly come out and say, you know, I don't trust you, especially in a work environment. But their actions will speak so much louder than just simply saying those words. They no longer bring you their issues. They no longer bring you their hard questions. The situations where they do not know what to do, they don't bring those issues to you anymore because you've let them down previously. When you didn't know the answer and you didn't want to expose your lack of knowledge, you simply evaded the question. And time is ticking. They think you're handling their business for them, and yet you've simply neglected to get the answer. They can't trust that. So they no longer bring us questions. They no longer bring us their major concerns. Hey, Scoop. They don't even ask for the, when there's something difficult to handle, you know, they will huddle with others and you will not be in the huddle. That's a clear indication that the trust has been eroded. And trust is the foundation of any relationship, a work relationship, a marriage, parenting, anyone outside and older than the age of 10, it's a trust factor. And so what I really want to say, even though they have, they get to answer the question, can I be trusted? They get to answer that question. But the responsibility to take the answer and run with it is 100% ours. We have 100% responsibility to take the answer, believe it, and then begin to fix it or begin to increase it. It's not the time to, well, and they, and that's why, and okay. Nobody wants to hear all that. If you asked, if you had the courage to ask, if you didn't have the courage to ask, did you have the courage to look around, observe what's not coming your direction, what's not coming your way? The responsibility, and that's the beauty of it, we can fix it. We can restore it. We can do the work that it takes because titles don't earn trust. You can be the CEO, the principal, the teacher, the daddy, the mommy, the, you know, executive. Titles will never earn trust. It is the person holding the title that has to earn and maintain trust with everyone else. It's a huge responsibility, but let me tell you, it's a showstopper. If you cannot be trusted to do what you say or to do what everyone is expecting you to do, the relationship is going to fall. The team is going to crumble. The family is going to be limited. Okay, and you know, that's just, I'm you know, heavy on leadership, and leadership is not easy. Leadership is not leadership only when it's convenient. When you're dealing with the little lightweight elementary issues, that's not leadership. They're not paying you all that to deal with elementary issues. So, you know, we just got to check ourselves. I hope I got mirrors all around me right now, and they're not just to check my eyeliner. You got to be able to look yourself in the mirror, hear the hard truth, and fix it. Okay? 100% of the responsibility for your level of trustworthiness falls in your lap. Let's do the work. Let's do the work. Rebuild it, repair it, do whatever it takes. Maintain it, increase it. Can you be trusted? Okay, until next time, take real good care of yourself. Share the video. Subscribe to my website so that you can get the blogs that come out on a weekly basis. Let's just stay connected. Let's, you know, help me impact lives. That's what I'm here for. Take real good care.